Lumion 25 just got released, and it's packed with new features that could save you hours of work. From AI-powered upscaling to ray-traced volumetrics, today I'll show you what's new and what you should care about most. And just so you know, there's a free trial on their site if you want to explore it for yourself later. Alright, let's get started with number 1, AI upscaling. We all know AI is becoming a part of our daily lives. Those who aren't taking advantage of these new tools are falling behind. If you are rendering ray-traced scenes with a low-end GPU, you know how demanding and time-consuming it can be. To help with this, Lumion introduces AI upscaling. This will render your scene up to 5 times faster, which is a real time saver for most people. Let me show you how this works. Here's a scene I've created that has some elements that can take up some time to render. Now just go to Photo Mode, select any scene, and click on Render. You will see a new toggle called AI Upscale. When you activate it, it will render an AI upscale image. And here's a comparison between the original and the upscaled AI version. This is only available for still images at this point, and the way this works for my tests is that it's enhancing the details, not replacing with AI creativity like we see in some apps like Krea AI or Magnific AI. The idea here is to be as true to your original image as possible, while giving you a ready image in 5 times less time. Now, moving away from AI and going back to traditional new effects, there is a cool new one that you can add to your projects. It's the new Volumetric Fog Effect. You can create realistic simulations of fog, volumetric sunlight, and volumetric lighting all in one effect. To add it to your scene, in photo or video mode, click to add effects. Then head over to Sky and Weather and select Volumetric Fog. It's the first one on the list. Watch how the scene changes as I adjust the fog settings. Note that you need to have the ray tracing effect enabled to be able to use this new volumetric fog. The water material now supports full ray tracing. It has better reflections and integration with global illumination. To add it to your scene, just select any water material from the material library. Now you can tweak the properties here. When you are done and ready to render, you need to select fully ray traced glass and water on the ray tracing effect to activate it. See how the reflections shift when we switch to ray traced water. There are some limitations though. It only applies to water materials, not oceans, waterfalls, or water planes yet. Now, the next feature is something that I was looking forward to. The Scene Inspector is a new tool that makes managing complex scenes much easier. This is available in Build and Build with Effect modes. In Lumion, when you click on the magnifying glass icon, it opens up the Scene Inspector. You can see all the files here, but if you click on this icon to filter, you can select just to display certain categories and model names, like imported models, nature, people and animals, and many other categories. If you click on a name, it selects all its objects. And you can click on a specific model to highlight and select it immediately. There's also a cool thing. You can hold Ctrl and it will select any category or model that you click on, allowing you to select multiple files. For someone like me using modeling software like 3ds Max or Modo, having a working scene inspector in Lumion is a big plus. What about you? Is it something you are happy to have now? Let me know in the comments below. I always read and try to reply to every comment you post. And by the way, if you would like to take your rendering skills to the next level, I invite you to check out my Lumion Render course. It has step-by-step video lessons that will help you master Lumion. I'll leave a link in the description below. Now, this has to be one of my favorites, the new Photogrammetry Tree assets. These are ultra-detailed assets that are photoscanned, bringing unparalleled realism to your designs. You can type in the search Photogrammetry to see all the new available assets. I've made several videos about this technique with different tools, including one that you always have with you, your phone. You can check the playlist up there and in the description below. Another one that is going to be quite useful is that you can flip objects directly inside Lumion. I'll grab this chess sofa and let me flip this real quick so you can see it in action. With just a button, you can quickly flip any object. This is currently only available for the transport and objects categories in the Lumion model library. I hope they will extend this to all the objects available in your library as well. That will be really useful. And if you don't have Lumion yet, you can get a free trial on their website. And from this new release, students can get Lumion Pro and Lumion View for free. I'll leave the links in the description so you can check them out. Now, the way Lumion saves and loads data has been completely re-engineered, and this brings faster save and load times. Just watch how fast the new saving work. Improvements like this are always welcome. Having software that feels smooth is really a big plus for me. And honestly, since Lumion 12, I've noticed that the software loaded a bit slower. Maybe that's because of the ray tracing and other things added. So it's nice to see that the Lumion team made progress in this area. Now, Lumion 25 now has a custom title bar, replacing the Windows one. Despite a cleaner look, we can also see here the ability to show the user login info and the new performance monitor, which, by the way, this leads us to the next feature. The performance monitor has a modern look now that fits better with the interface. You can immediately see if you have performance issues with the new speedometer, showing real-time frames per second, ranging from red from really low frames per second to full green when you have higher FPS and can work smoothly. By the way, here's what you can do if you are experiencing a red frames per second scenario. There are many ways, but I'll just give you the quick ones. In the performance center, you can adjust the quality. Let's reduce and see the difference. It looks better, but there's also the resolution. Let's set this to 50% and see the improvements. Another one you can activate is proxies. This will replace objects that are far away with blue lines, allowing you to work smoothly. I cover more tips on how you can make your Lumion faster in this video. And if you want to dig deeper into all the stats available on the scene, you can hover with your mouse over the performance monitor to view more detailed statistics. And speaking of making things faster, there's also a huge upgrade in how Lumion handles lighting. Let's check it out. In Lumion 25, areas that are dark in your scene will look much better and more natural. You'll see fewer flickering lights or weird moving blotches. This works for the preview window. Here's a comparison of the same scene with only 8 light bounces with Lumion 24 and 1 light bounce in Lumion 25. With this new improvement, the renders will look more stable and consistent, even without a lot of light bounces. And the improvements don't stop here. There's also new content available. Some of the new Lumion 25 assets are 14 new materials, 68 new nature assets, 7 ultra-detailed photogrammetry trees, 61 Mediterranean trees and plants, children and education themed asset collection, like playground and interior furniture, toys, materials, and decals. And also, if you are in doubt which ones are new, you can simply search L25 to find all the new assets from any category. There's also 2 new example scenes and 2 new templates and 8 new styles that were added, 3 of them which are from the top winners of the Rendering Style Challenge. And we also have Lumion View, which is a nice companion for those early design stages where you can quickly explore new design ideas, materials, and lighting. Lumion View is now available for download from the SketchUp extension warehouse, and you can try it for free for 14 days. Let me know in the comments if you want me to make a full tutorial for this. So, these were the best features for Lumion 25. Which feature are you most excited to try? Tell me in the comments. I'll be answering and maybe even making a tutorial about the most requested one. I will also be sharing more content soon about this new version, so stay tuned. Meanwhile, you can check this video where I show you step by step how to create amazing phasing animations. And that's it. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one.